Hi guys, welcome back to this video. Today I want to talk about some NCLEX mistakes that you probably don't realize that you're making. Taking the NCLEX is like very stressful. It's very overwhelming. It's like your whole nursing career really depends on that one exam. And regardless, like if you're a good test taker, bad test taker, whatever, you have to pass it to become a nurse. So I want to share a couple mistakes that I've noticed a lot of people make when they're preparing for the NCLEX. But before we get started, you need to know that this video is sponsored by Picmonic. Picmonic is a fantastic resource if you're in the boat of preparing for the NCLEX right now, or even if you're like in pathophysiology, maybe you've passed the NCLEX, but you're a new grad nurse. Picmonic is a great resource for you guys. What Picmonic is they offer fun, memorable stories that have visuals and pictures that make learning in nursing school fun. I'm just gonna do a little overlay so you guys can kind of see what I'm talking about. But when you're studying something, it's like really difficult to just sit there and look at flashcards or study notes or whatnot, but Picmonic makes it fun by sharing these stories and visuals to make it like a memorable experience. So for example, if you are learning about types of strokes, they'll have stories on there about strokes. And by telling the information in a fun and meaningful way, you're more likely to remember it. I'm gonna be sharing a couple other tips in this video of how you can use Picmonic to study for the NCLEX. But if you're interested in checking them out, make sure you go to the description box below. I will have a link so you can try out Picmonic for free. They also have an app that you can download as well, so you can do Picmonic on the go. But let's jump into a couple NCLEX mistakes that nursing students are making. And the first mistake is not realizing that studying for the NCLEX is a marathon, not a sprint. I hear so many nursing students say, oh, I'm just gonna study for the NCLEX once I graduate. You know, I'll take 2 months and study for it. But really what you need to do is be studying right now in little bits. So that way when you get to the NCLEX, you're feeling super, super prepared for it. Don't cram study all of that information that you need for the NCLEX in at the end when you can be doing little bits here now while you're in nursing school. Even if you're in your first semester, you should be preparing for the NCLEX. And what I recommend is just taking a little bit of time out of every week, maybe a couple hours during the month, and really sitting down and studying for the NCLEX by doing practice questions, reviewing your notes, reviewing old information. Take some time to be studying now versus cramming it all in at the end. The next mistake I see students make is not practicing enough NCLEX style questions. This is like hands down my favorite way to study, is practicing NCLEX questions over and over and over again. And if you apply my first tip of preparing for the NCLEX like it's a marathon, not a sprint, you can actually do questions throughout your nursing school career. So maybe starting with just doing 10 a day and building that up to 15, 20, and soon you'll be up to like doing 200 questions in one sitting. You really have to get used to sitting down and doing enough questions. So that way, when you get to the NCLEX, if you get, you know, 200 questions, you're prepared for doing all 200 questions and you're not getting burnt out. So making sure you're doing enough NCLEX style questions. Picmonic actually has NCLEX style questions already made up for you with the rationale, so you don't even have to come up with your own or find another resource when they have it all on the app for you. My next tip is to remember, and I know you guys are gonna be like, this is so cheesy, but it's true. Your first guess is usually your best guess. When you are taking the NCLEX, whatever answer comes to you first, that's most likely the correct answer. Don't keep changing it back and forth between, you know, whatever answers you're debating on. Just go with your gut. And if you get to a question that you don't know the answer to whatsoever, move on. Most likely, if you have no idea what the question is even asking, like, you're probably not just going to like magically remember it. Not saying that that can't happen, but just move on. Don't get anxious over the question, stress about it. It's one question, just throw it out, move on. I remember when I took the NCLEX, I started getting all these cancer questions, like on all these different types of cancers and chemos. And I was like, I don't know oncology. Like, I don't know this stuff. And so I was like, well, it's not like I'm gonna remember it if I've never learned it before. So I just went on to the next question and I ended up passing the NCLEX. Obviously I'm a nurse now, but if you truly don't know the answer, don't waste your time on it. Your first guess is usually your best guess. So just go with your gut and move on. My last tip for the NCLEX slash mistakes that nurses make is by not studying effectively and using like memory retention techniques. And what I mean by this is a lot of times in nursing school, students will study information and then they just like throw it out. They're like, oh, well, I already passed that test. Like, let me move on. But no, that information is going to come back and haunt you for the NCLEX. So all those basic things you learned in first semester and whatnot that you think, oh, I don't need to know this. No, it will come back on the NCLEX. So instead of just learning something and like shoving it out of your brain saying, oh, I don't need to know that, go back to the information and review it again. And this is a technique I've mentioned a million times in my videos. You guys are probably sick of hearing it. But if you are preparing for exam one and take exam one, you're done with exam one, okay, great. When you're moving on to exam two and studying the content for exam two, go back to the content from exam one and just briefly study and go over it. And Picmonic actually helps do this for you by helping review questions that maybe you didn't do so well on, or even you did do well on them. They create custom question banks for you so you can go on and review content. So when it comes back up again, you're more likely to remember something if you've seen it more than one time. So use that technique when you're studying for the NCLEX and for anything in nursing school, and it will only help you and benefit you. Those are my techniques. Those are the mistakes that people make for the NCLEX. I hope it was helpful for you all. Make sure you check out Picmonic. They're linked in the description box below. You can try them out for free. So many of you guys messaged me say you love them. They've helped you so much. You passed the NCLEX because of them, and it's very awesome to hear and humbling. So check them out. I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.